Hi guys, today I'm going to be showing you how I cut a dado with the Stanley 45. Now let me just explain how the work's set up. We've got a hold fast holding the work down onto the bench, a bench dog at the end of where the dado will be, but set low enough so it won't impede the cutter. And I've clamped on a piece of MDF, nice and straight edge, with a couple of F clamps onto the bottom of the bench as well. So it's all held very tightly. We've got a straight edge against which to reference the plane, set up right where we want our dado. Now when we run the plane, we can reference the side, in this case, because of the direction I'm doing it, the sliding section against the guide that I've put in. I'm going to be cutting a half inch dado, so I've installed the half inch cutter into the plane. I've got it loose and I'm just going to advance the iron so it barely sticks out below the main stock. And then I can tighten it up. I'm using the sliding section and I put the short rails on this time, and we move the sliding section across so that it lines up with the outside edge of the cutter. We've got two spurs just ahead of the cutter. Since we're doing cross grain work, we need to put the spurs or knickers into action. So twist them round so that a sharp spur is sitting proud of the main stock and also the sliding section. As with the cutter, it's most important to make sure that the spurs are nice and sharp too. I'll cover sharpening spurs in another video. And that's now ready to cut. The first thing I'm going to do is draw the plane backwards and cut in with the spurs. As you can see, the work's not totally flat, so we're skipping in places. I just realised that in my rush getting this set up, what I haven't done is put a backer board on here, which you should do to stop any tear out. What you can also do is just use a marking knife, and you would use a square beforehand just to score the end of the dado. And that's really quite easy, so I'm going to advance the iron a little bit. Just take a slightly deeper cut. Thank you. Now that I've established a little channel, I can remove the guide, and that will avoid it getting in the way of any of the parts of the plane as it goes deeper into the work. And whilst the clamps are off, I'll just put a backer piece in there, which I should have done to begin with. I just established the dado in the backer piece that I've popped in. And now I can continue with the plane riding in the dado. Just advance the cutter a little bit more to see whether we can speed up the cut, lower the dog down so that's not in the way. And we're taking really quite thick chips out now. Probably just about on the limit of what I can push in a controlled manner. As you can see, we've achieved a nice dado. The bottom of the dado is a little rough. We were taking some really quite thick shavings out of there. So I'll ease the cutter back a little bit in the plane, disengage the knickers, and just take a couple of passes to clean up the bottom a little bit. And that's just to improve things a little bit. When you're cutting a dado, you'll have a design depth for it, and that's where the depth stop, adjustable depth stop on the front of the plane, is brought into use. You lower it down for the correct depth from the bottom of the sole to the depth stop, and then plane away until it won't cut anymore. Dados with the Stanley 45, a piece of cake. Cheerio!